Hallelujah. It is a wonderful joy to come into the presence of God and to worship Him on this day. It says in the book of Luke that the birds of the air, that the lilies of the field, they do not have to worry because the Lord provides for them. The birds of the air, they do not have to worry about what and when their next meal will come from because the Lord God created them. How much more is the Lord gracious over our lives because He created us according to His own image. We are created just like Him. And when we thirst and long for the presence of God, for the presence of the Father, we will never lack anything in our lives. When we devote our whole lives into worshiping Him, to longing for more and more of Him, there is nothing we need to worry about. As the deer pants for the water, the Lord provides for it. The Lord takes care of all of its needs. And today, as we worship the Lord, as we give our hearts and our souls to worship Him, He will provide and take care of every one of your needs. So today, just give your very best unto Him. Open up your hearts, open up your souls, and worship the living God. For He is worthy of all praise. He is worthy of all glory. He is worthy of all honor. Let your soul cry out. Let your soul bless the Lord. Let your soul thirst for more of His goodness, for more of His presence. For He is a good God who looks after His children, who provides for them and does everything that His children need. So today, lift up your hands and worship Him, for He is an almighty and good God. As the deer panteth for the water, so my soul longeth after Thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship Thee. As the is for the water, so my soul longeth after Thee, Lord. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship Thee.
Say, you're my friend.
You're my friend.
and you are my brother, even though you are a king. I love you more than any other, so much more than anything.
We say again, you're my friend,
and you're my friend, and you are my brother, even though you are a king.
Lord,
I love you more than any other, so much more than anything.
Resolution in your heart today that your heart and soul will worship God alone, that in any situation and circumstance, no matter how difficult it may be, that your heart and soul will long and thirst for the living God. For even though He is the great King, He still came down and gave His life. He came down on this earth as a mere human so that He could give you His very life, that He could take up sin upon His own body and die on the cross so that we could all live. So why don't you take this moment right now and give your soul, give your heart, give your everything to the Lord.
Oh, we worship you, God, with all of our souls. We give you our worship. Lord, we give you our hearts and all of our souls. We give to worship you. lift my voice to words, the heavens, for you are my sun and shield. Oh, how my soul longs for you, longs to worship you.
Deserve all glory, O God. You alone deserve all honor. Your word says, O God, that when your people call out and cry out and knock on the door, Lord, that you will answer, that you will open that door and you will answer the cry of your people, God. For all those who cry out with their souls today, God, I ask that you fill them with your glory, Lord. Fill them with your glory, O God. For you are a glorious God. All honor and glory and power belongs to the Lamb who sits upon the throne. We worship you, Jesus. All honor and glory and power and wisdom and strength belongs to the Lamb, belongs to the Lamb, sits on the throne. And all honor, all glory, that again. You lift your hands and say, all honor, all glory, all power to you. And only Father, we worship you, precious Jesus, my Savior. Bible in Acts chapter 2, that when the people were waiting in the upper room, they came together in one accord. And when they came together, then the Holy Spirit came forth like the sound of a rushing wind, filled them with His Spirit, and all of them began speaking in tongues. All of them were filled by the fire of God. The reason why it happened was because they came together in oneness, not only with each other, but also with the Father God. When the Lord Jesus was resurrected from the dead, He told His disciples that wait in Jerusalem till the promise of the Father comes down. That is the Holy Spirit. And when they waited together in one accord, in one mind, waiting for the Spirit of the living God, they were filled with that fire. So today, why don't you, in one in unity with the Father, cry to Him for fire.
Again, all honor, all
you take a moment right now and thirst and hunger and ask for that fire. Because our God is gracious to give unto the people who will ask of Him. For those of you who need more of His fullness, of His goodness, of His fire, of His presence, of His glory to come into your lives, just ask Him and He will give it unto you. Jesus, oh Lord, your fire, God, your fire, Lord, revival fire, holy fire is falling down, is falling down. Oh God, falling down, falling down. Holy fire, revival fire, holy fire from heaven is falling down on me. Holy fire, revival fire, and holy fire from heaven is falling down on me. Holy fire, revival fire, and holy fire from heaven is falling down on me. Holy fire, revival fire, who asked of you today, oh God, that you fill them with Holy Ghost fire. Lord, we thank you, Lord, that even though your disciples and all of them, the 120 of them who were gathered on the upper room, they experienced your fire, God. We thank you that 2,000 years later, when we still ask of your Spirit, Lord, you release that very same anointing, that very same presence, that very same fire and glory, God. We thank you, Lord. All honor and glory and power belongs to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We worship you and bless your holy name. Amen and amen. Carry this fire and bring it forth to the rest of this world, because that is what the Lord Jesus commands us, that the uttermost parts of the world will know the gospel of the kingdom. just as how the disciples were empowered with this fire to go forth and minister and teach people of the gospel, in that same way, carry this fire and bring it forth to the rest of this world till the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you. Amen and amen.